So finally, your exams are here, and please go through all the 11 programs that are being shared to you in your WhatsApp group. So here I want to tell you that you had already revised a few programs on HTML. So I am here to explain you the PHP code and how to execute these programs. Okay. So initially, what you need to do is you have to check whether the server is installed or not. So how you are going to check that server? See. You're going to go to search and just put as a WAMP server. So if the server is installed, it will directly show you here and execute it from here. That is start WAMP server. Once the server is started, here you will notice that there is a white icon. So it will show you that the server is already started, right? So the second step that you're going to do is, if it is showing you red color or yellow color mark, again just click over here and again you can go for restart all the services. So here you can see the changes, yellow, red, and finally it will come as white, which will show you that the server is ready to run. Right now, second step what you have to do is, some programs may not run because there is a problem of port number. You have to go to Apache and then you have to go to http.conf. So here you have to check the server number. So we just keep on browsing the file. Here you will see that it is 80 because it is installed new in the lab. It will be 80, so you have to change it to 82 or 81. So if you are changing it to 81, remember that number. You can change to 82 or you can change to 81. So here at two places you have to make the changes. I think one more place is there where you have to make a change. See here, server name localhost. So there are three places in this file, http://d.configuration file. So you have to change this address at three places, then go for file and then go for save. So this will be the second step. Are you getting it? Okay. So this will be your second step. Finally, how you are going to start the server. So just click here, okay, and then you can go for localhost. So sometimes you may find that this is a default localhost, IIS Windows, whose address is 80. So now we had installed our server at 82. We have changed the port number, right? So once when you open the browser, check that your host is properly running. This is the third step. So if you are taking 81, put here 81. If you are taking 82, put here 82. This is the third step, right? Now you can see that my server is running correctly. So this is the third step. Now, what is the fourth step? Suppose this is the 11th program, which is for cookies. Just open Notepad and type the program, right? So put the tags properly, less than question mark and then PHP. Date underscore default time zone underscore set single quote Asia slash Calcutta and put a semicolon. So this will give you the date format of India. So these two are the comment lines. You can skip those. Then this is the format. In 2 months, 60 × 60 × 24 × 60 plus time. So this will show you the exact time, okay, and hours, minutes and everything, right? So set cookie last visit. So initially when you run the program, it will show you that some default values, but when you rerun the program, the cookie count, it will show you how many times the user have opened the file or visited the site. So this will show you the last visitor date. I will show you that during execution. Then if I visit today at 12:14, it will show 12:14 p.m. If I rerun it for the next time, it will show me the last visit, which will be 12:14 p.m., which will be my last unit, and that is stored in the cookie. Cookie is a you can consider that cookie as one of the PHP object where the data is stored, and then it will display the cookies, right? So first time it may show you like this. You have got some stale cookies when you run your program for the first time. So during execution, you have to show the examiner by running this program for 2 times. Okay. Then it will show you that the cookie execution is correct. Alright guys, now where you have to save this program? You cannot save this program in local folder. You have to go for C drive. Okay, in C drive there is a WAMP server. okay, where your server is installed, where your WAMP server is installed. It will get installed under C WAMP. After that, you have to go for WW folder, okay, WW folder, and there I have created one folder, that is WP lab. You can directly store as C:WAMP. Under www you have to save your program. Main thing, guys, don't save it as .html, you have to save it as .php. So I have saved it as cookies_program11.php. Do not save it as html, save it as .php. Okay, so this is the next step. Now how to execute the code? You have to go back to your local host, right? So after typing in any browser, what you can do, open the browser. After opening the browser, okay, what you do, you put 82, right? Local host colon 82, then you will see all the files. So your file will be here in your projects, which is nothing but WW folder. Click on WP lab, right? Here you will see the program, which should be compulsorily saved as .php, right? So which should be compulsorily saved as .php. You cannot save that program as .html, right? While saving, compulsorily you have to save it as .php. I will also show you the procedure how to save the program. Just let us run it first. See here. So I executed this program at 11:54 today before showing it to you. That is why it is showing me the timing and date. This is the output, guys. Okay. See, now once if I run it again, it is showing me I have visited at 12:16. So this, in this way you can show the examiner the output. Okay, so this is the program for cookies, which is your 11th program in the journal, but this is the 10th program for your lab, that is PHP to store current date time in cookie and display the last visited date and time upon reopening the same page, right? Okay, now how you are going to save this file? So just click on file, right, and then save. One more example I will tell you for showing how to save, right? Suppose, see, for example, you are creating new file, new, right? Suppose this is your 11th program, that is your cookie program, right? You have to save it like file, go for save as, right? Then you have to go to which path? You have to go to C program, then you have to go to WAMP server, in that go to www, right? So here what you are going to do, you are going to take it as cookie.php. so this is very important. If you save it as .html or .text, the program is not going to run. So all .php should be in the small case, and choose all files, okay, and just go for save. So in this way there is a procedure to save the file. So you have to save the file with .php extension. So once when I just open the localhost, okay, to confirm whether you have saved the file correctly, so you can go back to your C, you can go back to WAMP, you can go to www, and there just check whether you have saved your program correctly. See, this is a new code, just go for properties. Yes, so here it will show you that it is a PHP file. It means you have successfully created a PHP file. So this is the procedure to create the file. So this is all about your 11th program. So please remember the steps. So I will tell you about the next program in the next video. So wish just revise the steps. Okay, don't miss any steps. All the best.